closer.
Come a little closer.
Turn another page. Ooh. In the story of what's waiting for
waiting you. Waiting for you. Step into the wonder.
Step into the wonder.
Everything you picture. Oh, as it comes into you.
Come in the shop then! Oh, I forgot. Give me one sec. Come in the shop!
I'm just so
angry about it. It's just agreed! Yeah. It's agreed! I mean, how agreed does one need to be? Bonjour, by the way! Oh, bonjour! As you can tell, passions are flaring today, aren't they, Mick? Well, I just can't believe the same thing. I mean, how greedy does one need to get? Well, I know. Just bear a sec. Let's just do the welcome verse. Bon. Draw a bienvenue or opinion vanish to Disneyland and me. This is the show where we get to talk about our opinions on all things coming up. Past, present and future Disneyland Paris. You will literally bed the place down. Okay. I'm going to let you do most of the leading today because I feel you out of the two are strongly fired up on this topic. Yeah. I'm going to try and see what I can, but I'm going to let you lead, because I think that's the only fair way to do it. Yeah. So. Okay, so. Recently, I discovered this on Twitter. I can't remember which one of my friends it was. About the fact that the Fastpass are basically going. Yeah, they're going. And are being replaced by a new service. And I got confused because when I saw this tweet, I was like, oh, it's on the Premier Access. I thought, oh, it's Premier Access of Disney Plus going up. For the last people. And I was like, what? But then, oh no, it's a beep. I was like, what? Yeah. So, your wonderful free fast passes. That you've been managed to enjoy for how many years now? From this summer are no more. Disneyland Paris is going to be retiring its free Fastpass service, which of course lets visitors skip the queue lines, and will instead offer up the Disney Premier Access Program. Well, the name there for a start, stupid. I know, because that's confusing, because obviously. Disney Premier Access, you just think that just refers to Disney Plus, which that's also an evil invention. Could be Premier Access. Could be Premier Access, you have to pay, I think it's £20 to get certain films. So, like how we've seen during the pandemic, where some films, like Mulan's live action version, Cruella, they've gone Premier Access. But you have to pay £20 extra. On top of what you've already pay a month for Disney Plus as a whole. Yep. Just to get, yep. Greed. Greed. But this is greedier. Because once you're in the theme park, you should need to then have to pay for other services. No. Obviously you've got to pay to get your park ticket. But after that, you should only need to pay... need to fork out for money on food and beverages and souvenirs. Well, those are the three things I can see you only need to fork out more money on, not a fast pass jumping around. So, it's going to begin this summer. And they're going to start charging you if you want to basically skip the queue lines to certain attractions. Now, according to the theme park. This new service will help park goers enjoy the ability to skip the regular queue line for thrill rides, classic attractions and more. But they already did that! Yeah, they already did that! That's what you can do with a Fastpass. That statement is basically just explaining what Fastpass is. Mm-hmm. You can do all that with Fastpass, yeah? You know, that's the idea behind the Fastpass, is that you can, you go to a Fastpass machine, whether they're in the parks, yeah, either Disneyland Park or what Studios Park, yeah. You get a ticket, gives you a time print. Yeah, we haven't really done Fastpass, so I'm going to basically let you explain what Fastpass is. Right, you get a ticket, and between this particular time period and that particular time period, that's what you've got to get into your Fastpass. Yeah, so... yeah. We've never really done Fastpass. Yeah. But that's basically what it is. You get to basically jump the queue. Yeah. And you then go up to the Fastpass entrance on that particular ride. And you just show your ticket and then you're through. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't mean you jump the queue altogether. No, it just means that you go into a smaller queue. Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. But what was the benefit of Fastpass is it's free, you don't need to pay anything. And you can jump the queue to your favourite ride. Yeah, so if you've got a particular, favourite ride that you love, but the queue's too long, you don't want to deal with the queue, you go get a fast pass, and you can jump the queue between that particular time and your fast pass. Have you got any idea between the times, or is it bang on? So say for example, if you got a fast pass between 1 PM and 2 PM, have you got to go bang on 1 PM or? Well, I feel like you could go at any point during that hour. If you look it up on Disneyland Paris website, I'll bring it up. Yeah, I'm gonna bring it up. Yeah. Yeah, so basically, as you see, it says there, you basically just insert your Disney Park ticket into the bus machine. Yeah. You never see your Fastpass ticket, which shows your return time, and you've got to return to the attraction at your designated time. Right, see, yeah. Okay, yeah. Enter your buy the Fastpass entry for that ticket. Right, yeah. Okay, yeah. And basically, it's free service for any particular ride you want that does Fastpass. You could basically just jump the queue for. Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. Just. But. Of course, that is now ending. Yeah. It's now going to be. Paying. We've looked up how much you will need. To pay. Before we do, let's finish off reading the news. Disneyland Paris website states that visitors can use the Premier Access program by an app on their phones. Oh, that's gonna work, really. I mean, the Disneyland Paris app's not really that well up to date on a lot of areas, despite this new technological world, or by visiting locations within the park. So basically, what we probably will see happen is Fastpass machines go and it gets replaced with Premier Access machines. Yeah, except now it'll be more fiddler because if you put a Premier Access machine in, you'll have to insert your ticket in, put money in, and then there you go. Yeah, whereas with Fastpass, it's just been nice and simple. You put your Disney Park ticket in, you can get a ticket, and then simply, by the time that ticket says, you've got to be at the attraction pool. And you just skip the main queue. Yeah. And then you got a panel. Yeah. But of course, you don't skip the in-ride queue. Yeah. Because normally in a lot of attractions, they'll have in-ride queues. The queue to get into the ride, and there's the in-ride queue. Yeah. That you can't get. Yeah. Right. So prices, and this is where you've got the big problem. So, you'll have to pay between approximately €8 and €15, wait for it, per person, per ride. Greed. Utter greed. It's just plain greedy. And they have said that prices will change depending on the attraction and day of use, according to the website. So basically, some attractions could be €8. Some could be, say, €15, or some you could go in between the two. So maybe about €12. Do we know any attractions on this list? We do. So, initial attractions that are going to be featured in the Premier Access Program are going to include. Oh, let me bring it up. Okay, let me bring it up for you. Let me bring it up for you. They include. Hold on. Right, here we go. So the initial attractions that will be included in this product program are Big Thunder Mountain, Hyperspace Mountain, Peter Pan's Flight, Buzz Lightyear Laser Blast, Star Tours, Autopia, and then the two, and then there's just two attractions currently on what do you use park, Twilight Zone Tower of Terror, and Ratatouille Le Venture Tournament Tour de Remy. Right, so mainly it's going to be in the main park. Yeah. But I can imagine it will slowly creep into the Studios Park, especially once when the expansion gets towards 3/4 of the way done. Yeah. Could be. But it's just greedy. Oh yeah. And this is the new thing now. The Fastpass that you've got to know and love over the many years is not coming back. This is going to be the new deal now. So it's either you shell out 8 to 15 euros per particular ride, or you basically do what the rest of us do and go in the queue. It's not as bad as you think. Going in the queue ride is not as bad as you think. But obviously I do recognise there are some people who do obviously want to take a queue. Right. So, can I ask what that is in pounds? The price, yeah, okay. All right, I'll look it up. Right. So, should we just look at the minimum and the maximum? Right, so, €8 into equals £6.84. So basically roughly £7 in British money, and then €15 equals to £12.82. So if you round that up, that's £13. Yeesh, yep. Bloody hell, I know. Oh, just to get onto a ride quicker. I know. Go, you lead. I'll let you take the fall. Because I know you were you're very angry about this. Well, yeah, it's just plain simple greed. Okay, and plus, per guest, per ride? I know. They should give you just a premier access pass. Yeah, so, as well as have your park pass to get into the park, they should give you the option to purchase a premier access pass where you could pay, say, the maximum, so €15, and that way you can get in. That way you just show the card at any premier access, rider's got premier access, and just go in. Huh? Because if you were, right, so if you were a party of four, and you wanted to use a ride that had premier access, if they were to charge you the lowest price, that would be £32 in total. But if you were to go on a ride that was to charge you the maximum, so €15, that would be in total €60, and that's per ride. Right. So if you wanted to do 4 different attractions in one day that had premier access, you would basically have to pay in total €240. Is it the maximum? Yep. What was the minimum? Is it the minimum? So, if it was the minimum, €128. And that's if you had a party of 4. Wow. That's €240 to go just to jump a queue. Scandal, yep. Scandal, yep. Utter scandal. Just to jump a queue. It doesn't make sense. Now, we don't currently know if American Parks are going to do this. But if they were, I bet you the prices will be a bit more expensive. In fact, I think the article that I've just read from actually has given you the conversion in dollars. So let's do that. Oh, got it. Right. Right. So, €8 is the equivalent of $9. And €50 is the equivalent of $18. So, if they were to brawl this out into American Parks, let's now do that. Let's see, would it be worse in American Park? So if you do 18, yeah, times 4, yeah. So it would cost you $70 for one ride. But if you were to do, say, 4 rides, oh, so not that much. There's an increase. It would cost you $288 if they rolled this out in the American Parks, and that's for a party of 4 to do 4 rides per access. So basically, if it was rolled out in America, it'd be pricier by about $48. Yeah, that's the difference. I just can't. But we don't know yet if this is going to get rolled out in American Parks. Parks. But if it did, then you are literally just taking the utter piss. Oh no! Oh! Well, I think we should. I mean, I'm surprised you've not sworn yet. I'm trying to hold it in. Yeah, well. But no. Let's go back to the French side. €240. And that's if you do a party of 4. And that would just go up. That would then just go up and up and up and up. But it's literally... But it's not worth it. It's not worth you having to pay. That's what really infuriates me. Is the fact that it's got to be per person, per guest. So, like I said, if you're in a party of 4, you can't just basically pay one per actor ticket for your whole party. You've got to do it per guest. Which would never allow them need to give you your, probably give you their, this park art pass. It's just dick. I think they've got this pricing scheme wrong. Per guest per ride. It's ridiculous. Well, he just did it one. What would the figures be if he did the price for one guest, but for a party four on four different rides? Okay, let's look it up. Would it be that? Be the two, wouldn't it? Oh, sorry, do you mean 15 times four? Yeah, oh, sorry. Yeah, so the price for one ticket, but for party four, to do it on one ticket. Oh, in that case, it would just cost you £60. Yeah, £60. So you would say, God, trying to flip it together. Right, so you say you could pay the price for four with one ticket, that would probably cost £60. Which is still quite unreasonable. Perhaps still quite unreasonable, but it'd be less price. But it would be a whole lot less pricier than having to pay four tickets for a party of four to go on four premier access rides. It's disgusting, utter greed, and I'm reading into this thinking this is to help improve guest experience, but how does it improve guest experience if you're having to shell out extra money to go to skip a queue for a ride that only lasts about 5 minutes? Five, six, maybe six, 7 minutes. Yeah, absolutely. It's not worth it. I mean, you'll find in a lot of Disney park rides, the queue are like, you could be in the queue for, say, 45, 60 minutes and be on the ride for, say, about 7 or 8 minutes. Is that ridiculous? It's not worth paying that. No. You may as well do what I should do and just stay in the queue, just stick in the to the queue, just stay in the queue. You're gonna go on the ride eventually. You know, just brave the queue. Yeah. But that is where I've got the problem. This looks like it's a thing to help with guest experience, but it doesn't. And you've got to remember that most people, majority of your park guests, will have saved up for months and months and months and months and months, to afford to get into the park in the first place, and now you are made them shell out an extra 130 €200 to €240 for them to jump a queue for a particular ride because you want to get ride because you want to get rid of I agree with you. This the way it's been worded, it does look like that This is the new permanent way if you want to skip a queue ride. If you want to skip a... That probably seems to be the way things are going now in Paris, is that if you want to skip a queue ride, you gotta pay £60. You gotta pay £60. Per ride. Per ride. That's where I've got the issue. It's per person, per ride. Why? Just utterly ridiculous. Utterly disgraceful. If this was a thing to help make up revenue losses because of the COVID virus, I still would not accept it. No, you would. No. So either this was just a temporary fix to help boost up revenue that's been lost because of the pandemic, you still would not be happy. No. You're having to pay £60 per ride, per guest, to jump a queue. That is all it is. There's no logic in that. No business sense in that. Right? And we know by watching The Apprentice. Yeah, there's no logic to it whatsoever. This is not going to help you make money. It's going to help money. It's not going to work. It's not. But you'd be happy. If for me, this was announced as a temporary measure to help get back some losses from the pandemic. Remember, you've had a shutdown for a very, very long time because you reopened in June 2020 and then October 2020 you closed again and you've not been open for very, very long. Well, it was only about June. About June the 12th? June the 17th? About 2021? You've been reopened, so you've not been reopened that long. So, if this was a way to sort of help boost revenue to generate lost revenue because of the pandemic, it could be a temporary thing. Okay, I'd be like, well, okay, fine. Because every business has suffered because of the pandemic. Pandemic. And every business has got to try, as we try to get out of the pandemic, every business, no matter what sector it's in, has got to find new ways to recuperate their revenue losses. So if this was one of those ideas to generate lost revenue, I was just going to be a temporary fix. I would not have a problem with it. But for this to be a permanent thing, so you're going to get rid of something that proved quite successful for well over nearly 30 years, and replace it with a cash cow scheme, because that's basically what this is, then I have to say you're barking mad. Right, you are barking mad. Because that's not going to help your revenue. No, that's not going to help matters. Right. It's the money that really scandals me. Can I do a little quick test to see what it would have been like if they lowered it? So let's say €5. Go on. Right. Well, we know 5 fours are 20, so he had 20. So to do one ride would be 20, the pie four would be €20. But then to do four different rides per access, it would be €80. Don't maybe do half of 15! Don't maybe do half of 15! Okay, what about €12 then? Okay. So that's what we know if 4 euros was the minimum, what would it be if 12 euros was the maximum? Okay, we'll do that. Yeah, we can do that. Well, to do one premier access ride with a party of four would cost you €48. So to do four different premier access rides with a party of four, that would cost you €192. So that's probably not as bad compared to what the actual price things are. So that's not too bad, but it's still nearly well over €195 spent on getting passes to jump a queue ride. It just does not make sense. Well, I know you're not happy about this, but if they had used the model that I just used there, would you then be happier? So say, minimum €4, maximum €12, would you then be more happy with that? Maybe. Okay. You still want to lower the maximum, but I don't see them lowering the maximum to anything less than 12. So you're stuck with that. So that's actually going to be, so that's your best price, I'm afraid. He has to pay a maximum of €12. That's the maximum you have to pay. Well, that's not too bad. What we just did there. Okay, so Would you have to go on the record for this, because you know this is being recorded, would you have to go on the record and say, if it was low, the lowest you had to pay was €4 and the highest was 12 euros, would you then be happy with this? I think it would be more manageable than 8 and 15 euros, yeah. Because we've been working out this out with party falls. As long as you've got to remember, the more parties you have in your party, the higher you're going to want to pay, for, you're going to have to pay for each ride. And I would have that as a fixed price. You'd have that as a fixed price. Yeah. So for all... Yeah. So for all attractions you'd that go on the ski, you'd say either be €4 or €12. Yeah. Because that's no issue I've got, is that the prices are going to vary depending on the attraction. Yeah. And as we've seen plenty of times from many, many years of The Apprentice, whenever you keep mucking about the pricings, it does not work. Now, it always on The Apprentice causes an argument with the PM and the... Because members of the team, they will be willing to change the price, we'll change the price. And PM's like, no! This is the price, we're sticking to it. Yeah. It really needs... If you're going to do this, you need to just go with a fixed price. Yeah, so class these attractions in that price, that's going to be €8. Class these attractions, they're going to be under €10. These attractions are going to be €50. Yeah, and not just go woody ninny ninny. Yeah, but that's basically what they're going to do. Yeah, basically they're going to, each day, they're going to look at the attraction, see how it's being in use, and they're basically going to, that's what the price is going to be. Yeah, absolute ridiculous. Well, if I was a betting man, I could probably guess that Ratatouille, Le Bencher, Tout le monde, Tout de Remy is going to be at the maximum of €15. Yeah. Because ever since that arrived, that has proved to be a very, very popular attraction. You get massive queues for that. So it would not surprise me if Ratatouille gets straight away put on the list of maximum price. It would not surprise me if that was €15. Just the greed. I know. But that's what businessmen are like. Businessmen are greedy, greedy bastards. I don't care now. We've gone past. We've got to let the anger out one way or another. That's what businessmen are like. Most businessmen are like. They're greedy, greedy bastards who only care about how they can make money for themselves rather than the customer experience. And that's what business needs to focus. Businesses need to focus more on customer experience rather than money, 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 money! If you focus less on the green, then your business would thrive more because you'd be able to give customer experience rather than focus on the money. And you know what I would really, really love to know? I would love to be in the park right now collecting market research. I'd love. Because we've never ever done Fastpass. No. We've never done Fastpass. No. And we won't be doing it now on the Premier Access because we're not shelling out. 60 quid per ride. No, we're not doing that. No. We'll stand in the queue and queue and still have all our money. Yeah. We'll spend our money the right way, which is on food and beverages and souvenirs. Yeah. We're going to do it the right way. We're not going to be these idiots to splurge. Could we splurge just to get on the ride quicker? Yeah. But I would love to be in the park with a clipboard and asking people who have used and stand by the Premier Access machines that they're probably going to put in. Right, I would stand by them and go, right, so what do you make of the Premier Access? You know, do you like the Premier Access? Have you got a better question? What question will you ask? Oh, okay, right, okay. I'd ask, so what do you make of Premier Access? Do you think Premier Access is a good thing? Do you see value for money? Right, value, because that's what we always ask in business. Do you see value for money? Right. What are the benefits to this Premier Access? And the most important question, what would you want to pay less for the Premier Access or more for Premier Access? Right. So, I would love to be there. Maybe you could do it on your next trip. No! I'm not that sad. No, but you could if you're waiting for a parade. Literally design it. Design the questionnaire and try to ask somebody, how do you use Premier Access? I'm not going to do that! But you could! No, I'm not going to just go walk up to a random park guest and say, what do you make of Premier Access? Would you mind answering some questions? I'm not going to do that. For all we know, they might not speak English. They could be Spanish, for all we know. I don't know any Spanish. Are you sure? But literally, they need to get somebody to do that. They need to put somebody next to whatever machines they're going to have for to get your Premier Access. Yeah. Have somebody stand by there, ask people a couple of questions, and use that to determine how this is going. Yeah. Is there anything you should do? I'm not going to do... I am not. Whenever my next trip is, I am not going to make a questionnaire so I can ask random guests what they think of Premier Access. I'm not. Okay? But what I will ask is, any viewers, if you have don't use Premier Access, because we don't know where it's rolled out. No. We know it's come down, it's rolling out in the summer, but we don't know officially where it's rolled out, so it might already be, it might not have been rolled out by the time we put it in the video. But once it has rolled out officially, my dear viewers, if you have used Premier Access once it's rolled out, I would love you to get in touch with me. You know, you can do it by the comments below. Actually, no, email's better. Right, email's better in the comments because we don't need to have massive comments. No. So do it by my Gmail. This might be a good point to bring my email address up on the screen again. Right, make a note of that. Yeah. So obviously you have it at the beginning, because obviously I give these to the past, and it's hard to get people in touch with my email at the beginning of the show, but we'll do it here, just to remind you. Yeah. So, get in touch with me by my Gmail. My address is coming up on the screen now. Okay, make a note of it. Get in touch with me. Let me know if you have used Premier Access, what are your thoughts on it? Okay? And do you think the price... And also, I'd love to hear in particular what you make of the pricings, because we, as you've heard, think it's just pure utter greed. Mm-hmm. But what about you? What do you do? Because obviously we don't use Fastpass. Right? We've never used Fastpass. We're not going to use Premier Access. So we need our... So for us, this is unknown territory. Yeah. We're just giving our general thoughts on the whole idea. Yeah. But what I want to hear is from you guys that are going to use this, because I want to know what your thoughts are. But don't do it by the comments below, because it'll be too lengthy. It will just be too lengthy. Okay, don't. Get in touch with me by my Gmail instead. My address is on the screen. Note it down. Get in touch with me by Gmail, and I'd love to hear your thoughts. And who knows? If we get a decent amount of feedback, we could maybe do a video where we get to where we read them out. Right, and hear what other people think. Yeah, that'd be a good way. Yeah, that's what we should do. So. Get in touch with me by my Gmail. I might end the show. But don't do our comments on the YouTube. It'll be too lengthy. And we won't get a chance to... I won't read them properly. We'll just have to just go... Yeah, you commented. Skip. Next comment. Just get in touch with me by my Gmail. Because that way, you'll have more freedom to say what you want to say. And you'll have a better chance of me reading it rather than your comments on YouTube. Okay? So just do it that way. Okay? Because I'd love to know what you guys that are going to use this... What are your thoughts on it? Especially with those particular questions like what you make of Premier Access and do you see it buys money and would you want to pay more or less? So those take three areas. But if you want to go put that's done. Right. So I think we're pretty much covered. I honestly don't want to go anymore. It's just pure greed. I'll let you have the final word before I chip in and sign off. Okay. Final word all yours. I personally just feel this is an utter greed. Okay? This is not going to be value for money. Well, something might disagree with me. That's my fault. Yeah. If it was temporary, we could maybe get through it. But because we know it's not going to be temporary, that I've got the problem. Do you really are just... No. Well, unfortunately, this is the future. This is the future. And unfortunately, past guests are going to be shelling out 32 to 60 quid per ride. Disgusting. Can we leave it? Yes, we'll leave it there. Thank you for watching, as always, my dear friends. Like I say, if you've got thoughts, don't do it by the comments, because it'll be just too, it'll just be too lengthy. Get in touch with me by Gmail. It's on the screen. That's my Gmail address. It's on the screen. Note it down. Get in touch with me. If you are going to use Premier Access, or depending on if this video comes out, and it's now rolled out, and you have used it, what do you think of it? Let me know. We'd love to hear from you. Because remember, we have just given you our side of the argument, and we don't use Fastpass or plan to use Premier Access. So I want to hear your side. It's that people are going to use it. So, thanks so much for watching. And until next time, what's left for us to say is, merci de bon regarder, just cannot to push on spectacle. Au revoir! Well, thank you for joining us for another amazing video. To see more, check out our most recent upload here, or why not check out that featured playlist? And don't forget to subscribe. What are you waiting for? I highly recommend it.